Hi, welcome to my channel. I'm Shamaptin. Today I'm going to review two things from Bioderma Pigment Bio range and one from their Cica Bio range. I wanted to review this for such a long time. I don't know why, because I was being lazy, that's why. I just wanted to review it because I don't want to take this, you know, projects to next year. From next year, I have so many things to do. I mean, YouTube content wise, I have so many ideas, so I don't want to drag these things. So let's start. First, I have their Pigment Bio cleanser. So the cleanser, it has citric acid as the second ingredient. That made me like, okay. But it can be due to like pH adjusting thing. If it is balanced with other ingredients, then it can be okay. And this cleanser, I won't call it my everyday go-to cleanser. So I use this like maximum twice or four times in a week at night. And it has this exfoliating granules, which feel really gentle on the skin though. But yeah, I won't do this every day. It feels gentle on the skin. It didn't like give me skin irritation or something. It didn't dry out my skin. But still, the texture wise, I mean, with all this exfoliating bits, I won't like, you know, use this every day or every night. So if you're looking for a gentle exfoliating cleanser that you can use like for twice in a week, then you can try this one. And about removing pigmentation, it actually helps the process, because whenever I got like pigmentation, I use this cleanser and somewhat it works, and I think it helped the healing process. But I have to tell you, I have used arbutane, then niacinamide, other treatments as well, so even those things were helping me as well. But if I have to create a like one entire anti-pigmentation routine where I want to speed up the healing process, then I think this one can help me out. But definitely, like I'm telling you, I'm not gonna use it like every day or every night. Or I mostly use this, you know, when I get pigmentation. I feel nice about it, and even the exfoliating bits are quite nice. It has gentle surfactants as well and few moisturizing ingredients that can nourish the skin while cleansing. Next thing I tried was their Pigment Bio night cream from this line, and this has one this vitamin C derivative and niacinamide. Squalene, I think, is the third ingredient, and it has sugar probiotics that can nourish and moisturize the skin. The ingredients are really good. It has fragrance though, but it didn't irritate my skin. I think this is one moisturizer with fragrance I've tried after 1 year. Yeah, and it didn't do anything bad to my skin, so yay to that. And about fragrance, I'm thinking if a thing is good, if I think the formulation is nice, then I'm gonna take a chance. Like, I can include a moisturizer with fragrance or one or two products in my skincare routine with fragrance. I'm talking about leave-on skincare stuff. You know what just happened? A thing from here, like this furry things, went here, and I was feeling like sneezing. I still feel like sneezing, you know. This is not that good. It looks cute and all, but these things, you know, come off. Okay, anyway, it's not a review for this sweater. I'm gonna talk about my Pigment Bio night treatment. So yeah, I expected it to have cream texture, but it has this gel texture, which is very nice. Doesn't feel sticky, absorbs well. But the thing about this night cream is that I have finished it. Alright, I have the empty container, so I tried to find the my old videos where I can show you the texture, like a texture of this night cream. I won't buy it again because number one, I use niacinamide serum, then vitamin C serum, so I don't think I need a moisturizer with these ingredients, and I feel like I'd be overdoing it, and this is kind of expensive. If I have to simplify my skincare routine, like I'm only using cleanser, a toner and moisturizer, then I'm gonna use this moisturizer because it has very good antioxidants and skin brightening ingredients. For a simplified routine, this moisturizer can be really good, but for a complicated routine like mine, like essence, serum, emulsion, this and that, I don't think I need this one, to be very honest. If you're looking for a simplified skincare routine and you want a brightening moisturizer, then you can try this one. And then I tried their Cica Bio Arnica. I like their Cica Bio original more because it works better for irritated skin, to be very honest. But if you want to apply this Cica Bio on your entire face, then choose the Arnica one because it has better texture for applying all over the face. And if you're looking for a spot treatment, then I think the Cica Bio original gonna be better texture wise. So this is the thing, and the ingredients are kind of similar, but there are a few differences. The original Cica Bio has few good components of Centella, where this Cica Bio Arnica, it has Arnica flower extract. It doesn't have those components from Centella, but this Cica Bio Arnica, it has this phospholipids, which can be really good for our skin's barrier. It is very moisturizing. It keeps skin the hydration very good. So I'm saying these things. If you're looking for a soothing moisturizer for all over your face, then you can try this Arnica one. But if you're looking for quick spot treatment, if you get like rash and you want to fix it quickly, you can go for the Cica Bio original. So yeah, that's all. I hope you found this to be helpful, and thank you so much for watching. And yeah, let me know if you have any questions regarding these things, and see you very soon. Bye bye.